Hello, student of class 3. Today I am going to take you a audio class about the chapter birds. I have already sent you four video classes. Now I am going to read the chapter properly. Okay, all of you read the chapter at home properly. When you read it, you'll find the middle important points and what sentence, what points we have to underline. I will give you hints, okay? So in the page number 39, birds flying, okay? Birds have feathers on their bodies. They have wing instead of arms. We have two arms. But birds have what? Two wings. Most of them can fly with the help of these wings. So, what are the uses of the wings? The wings help a bird to fly in air. Their other body parts are also made in such a way that it is easy for them to fly. The structure of and the shape of the bird is also important. The shape of the bird helps the bird to fly in air. Turn the page number 40. Most birds have light bodies because their bones are thin and hollow. Very important point. All of you do underline with the help of pencil. With a pencil, birds have light bodies because their bones are thin and hollow. Very important point. I have already sent you a picture of the hollow bones because when the bones are hollow, there is nothing inside it. Okay? We have a solid bone. So our bones are heavy. But the bones of birds are light. Remember it, okay? Very important point. Their bodies are shaped like airplane. Actually, human designed the shape of the airplane from the structure of the bird. I have already told you in the one classes through the one video that birds have aerodynamic shape. Aerodynamic means what? They can move very easily through air without any obstacles. Okay? And it also called streamlined body. Aerodynamic and another word is what? Streamline. Remember, two words. The words are not given in the books. You can some idea from the Googles also. If you type the word aerodynamic shape and the word streamline, then you will get a picture of the meaning through the Googles. Okay? This helped them easily cut through air. Birds have strong arms and chest muscle. They have a strong chest muscle. These muscles help them to flap their wings for flying. Look at the picture, the flapping, the up and down movement of the wings. The up and down movement of the wings are called what? Flapping. Flapping of the wings. And another also flying bird use, this is called gliding. When they open their wings in the air high up in the sky, they don't flap. They take some rest and open their wings. So they can, this is called what? Gliding. Actually, bird have two types of flying. One is flapping and another is gliding. Okay? When you type the word in a Google about the flapping of the wings and gliding, then you will get the details. Okay? With that, you can take the help of internet. And next, feeders. As you know, a bird's body can contain more than how many wings? More than 10,000 feeders. There are three kinds. We classify according to their functions. Three kinds of feeders. Down feeders are fluffy. Do underline. Down feeders are what? Fluffy. They keep the bird warm. Very important. Do underline. They keep the bird body warm. So, they protect the bird skin from cold wind. When we feel cold, we wear sweater or jacket. But birds have feathers which cover the whole body and skin, so we protect and keep the body warm. Next, body feathers cover the body and give a shape to it. Body feather means what? They grow above the body and give a smooth shape of the bird, and it's make it streamlined body. Okay, this is the body feeders. Very important. Down feeder, body feeder, then what? Flight feeders are long feeders in the wings and tail. They help the bird to fly. These are long. Look at the picture. The pictures are given in the page number 40. Body feeders, down feeders, and the what? Flight feeders. Flight feeders are long. These feeders help the bird to fly in air. When they open their wings, you can see the flight feeder of the birds. If you type in the Google, then you can see the different colorful pictures of the flight feeders of the birds. You can take the help of internet and you type the word flight feeders, body feeders, down feeders. I have already given about the pictures of these feeders, but you can search in Google, okay? Again, it will help you. There are about 9,000 kinds of bird. Some birds such as ostrich and the kiwi cannot fly. So some birds cannot fly because their body weight is very heavy and their wings are short. Those birds can fly, they have a long wings like eagle, vulture, crane, okay? They can fly, but some birds cannot fly. Very important. Some birds can fly very high in the sky. And nesting habits. Nesting habit means what? When bird build nest when they have to lay eggs. Very important. Do underline this sentence. Birds build nest when they have to lay eggs. Jetia sorai ki hoy puali janma dibar samoy hoy tetia thali ki hoy build their nest baatu khajibo. They build nest in all kinds of places. They are mostly made high up in trees, but some birds build nest on the ground. Look at the pictures. Now nesting habit. The picture of eagle, picture of tailor birds, in the page 41, woodpecker, Look at the tree holes. And another bird nests on the ground. Partridge sitting in its nest on the ground. So different places, trees. I have already sent you the pictures of different nesting habit in the previous video. If you saw it, then you will find the different pictures. Or you can search in the Google the nesting habits of birds. Then you will get different colorful pictures, so beautiful pictures, and different nesting nest. Okay. When the nest is ready, the female lays eggs in it. Either the male or the female sit on the eggs to keep them warm. It's very important. Do understand? Why? When the female bird lay eggs, they have to maintain the temperature of the egg to develop the baby inside the egg. So when the birds sit on eggs, it keep the egg warm. When the eggs are warm, then the birds, baby bird develop inside it. When the temperature going down, the bird, baby bird cannot develop inside the egg. So birds have to maintain the temperature about to 40 degrees Celsius. Do you know the body temperature of a human being is what? 37 degrees Celsius. But the body temperature of a bird is what? 42 degrees Celsius. So when a bird sits on its eggs, the temperature is rise and gradually what? Baby bird develop. In a few days, the eggs break up open and the baby bird come out. This is called what? Hatching. Do underline the word hatching. Okay. Usually they have no feathers and are blind. When a baby bird come out from its through hatching, it has no feathers and are blind. The eyes are not opened, blind. The baby bird cannot see anything at the, when it's hatching. So the parent look after them and feed them until they are ready to fly. Until they are ready to fly out. So the parent bird what? Look after. They feed them. They collect the insect, different foods, grains, and feed the baby birds. And gradually what? Inside the nest, the baby bird develops. And feathers start to grow. They can open their eyes. The parent bird then also leave the nest. What? When the baby bird fully grown and ready to fly, then parent birds what? Leave the nest. Then no use of this nest. They leave it. They build new nest when they have to lay egg again. So when a bird built a nest and lay eggs after the when the hatching, the baby bird grow, and when the baby bird start to fly, that there are no use of the nest. They leave it, the nest. Okay, very important thing. Then when the times come again to lay eggs, they build new nest. Very important thing. And next topic is what? Beaks. Birds do not have teeth. Do underline. They have beaks which help them to eat. They use their claws to catch food and also to protect themselves. They use their claws. Claws means what? Feet. Some birds, such an eagle, eat the flesh of animal. They are flesh-eating birds. Other like sparrow eat fruit, seeds and grains. As you know, different birds eat different kind of foods. Birds have claws and beak, which are suitable for their eating habits. Do underline, very important thing. Birds have claws and beaks, which are suitable for their eating habits. And beak and the claws means feet help a bird to collect the food. A flesh-eating bird, such as eagle or vulture, has a strong, sharp beak shaped like hook. It helps to tear the flesh. Very important point, you do underline. In the next page, you have seen the picture, a beak of an eagle. How it look? Very sharp and curved-like. Look at the picture in the page number 42. All the pictures given, define beaks. Next point, a seed-eating bird, such as sparrow, has a short, pointed, strong beak used to crack seeds. So this is important. Seed-eating birds like sparrow, when they have a short, pointed beak, then use the beak to crack the seeds. When they collect a grain like paddy, they use to remove the outer hard coat and eat the rice inside the coat. Okay, they use their beak to crack the seeds. Next point, a parrot eats seeds, nuts and fruits. It has a strong curved beak, which is used to crack nuts and seed. Parrot, a very beautiful bird, is a curved beak. So it used its beak to crack the nut. Gosok guti bo bhangi bo kane use kore. Next, a woodpecker has a long sharp beak, which help it to tap the bark of a tree and pull out insect. What? The woodpecker can make a hole in the bark of a tree. They have a very hard beak, long, and they can make a hole on the bark of the tree. Gosha bakoli to kikoi padari, phuta kori belaba. And that kikoi inside the tree, some insect grow. They collect the insect. They have a very hard beak. If you search in the Google, then you can get the videos about the woodpecker. I have already sent you one video how woodpecker make a holes in the tree. Next, a duck has a broad flat beak with two holes on each side. Do underline. A duck has what? A duck has broad flat beak with two holes on its side. It takes muddy water in its beak. Mud and water flows out through the holes. Look at the picture, the beak of a duck and the two holes. Look at the holes. And plants and insects remain in the mouth and are eaten. Though they collect the food from the muddy water. So they have a broad and flat beaks. Next, last point is what? Birds like kingfisher and pelican have a long scissor-like beak for catching small fish. Scissor-like means what? Kesikhononista. Very sharp. Long. And it helps the catch insect in the water. Okay, this is about the beaks. In the next class, I will discuss with you about the feet and the claws. Very important part of a bird. Okay, bye.